My name is Arundhati and welcome back to the Aham Yoga Challenge. This video is part of our Do More Yoga campaign for 2018, where we put out a new video every day so that you can roll out your mat and practice a little more yoga at home. Today's video breaks down the Vinyasa Sun Salutation, and if you are a little familiar with yoga, you know that Vinyasa A and B Sun Salutations are extremely popular and widely practiced nowadays with good reason. So we're going to break that down. If you are a beginner, I suggest you go back to yesterday's video and watch the classical sun salutation before you start working on this one. Okay, so let's get started. Munch is going to join us for today's video again. Munch is my 5-month-old German Shepherd puppy. Luckily, he is napping right now. I have rolled out another mat for him, but he wants to be on this one. Okay, so hopefully you won't get too excited in the middle of the video. So let's get started. So all you need for today's practice is a yoga mat. And don't worry about how tight or flexible you are, how strong you are. All of that develops with a consistent yoga practice. Alright? So starting, you'll be on the top of your mat. Feet together. You roll both shoulders back. Tadasana. Reach your arms all the way towards the mat. Tuck the hip points towards the ribs. Okay? Keeping the chest lifted. Take your arms overhead. Now, if your shoulders feel open enough, palms can meet, okay, without the elbows bending. But for this video, I'm going to leave my arms open because that helps to keep the chest wider. You reach up here, then you flip the palms, you reach through the fingertips, you lengthen from the base of the spine, and you fold it. Drop the head at this point. And if you can't get all the way here, you stay at the next point where you're halfway up. You're pushing against the shins, lengthening the spine, giving your hamstrings time to open up. And from here, you bend both knees down, press your palms down, step back into high plank. And then you move forward slightly, keep and begin to lower down. So you bend your elbows, hug the elbows in, and pause halfway. From here, uncurl the toes, roll the shoulders back, and you come into your next pose. Then you curl your toes in and you lift your hips high up and back, feet and hands, shoulder width apart. You stay here for a few rounds of breath. And looking ahead, you take a giant step forward. You reverse it. You come halfway up and then you refold all the way back down. Then you reach your arms from the sides, press the feet, tail drops. And you join both palms at your heart center. Okay? As we move ahead, I'm going to start labeling the poses and also giving you a few modifications. Okay? So you reach up, and if you have lower back issues, you bend your knees, or if your hamstrings are really tight, you bend your knees and you lengthen your spine instead of going for the straight leg right away. Okay? And if the folding doesn't happen, just stay halfway up. Then coming halfway up, Ardha Uttanasana. Plant both palms down, step back into high plank, Chaturanga Dandasana, four limb staff pose. So you lower down, travel with the hips and shoulders together. If you're new, it's okay to go all the way down. Quick check that your palms are at your mid chest here, otherwise your shoulders will be out of alignment. Then you pick up, roll the shoulders back, weight is on your arms, shoulder and wrist in one line, uncurl your toes, lift the knees and hips up a little, up dog. Keep rolling the shoulders back, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Curl the toes in, lift your hips up and back, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Feet are shoulder width apart along with the hands. Stay here for a few rounds of breath. And look ahead. And take a giant step forward. And you come halfway up, Ardha Uttanasana, inhale. And slowly slide the hands down, full Uttanasana, folding in. Coming all the way up, back to Urdhva Namaskar. And joining both palms at your heart center. So it's a really short sun salutation. Okay, so if you're pressed for time, it's a really good one to do. Now let's add the breath for one more round. There is the vinyasa jump back and jump forward. You jump back into high plank and you jump forward from down dog. I'm not going to do that in this video for two reasons. This is just an introduction and breaking down Vinyasa A. And if I start jumping, I have a feeling this guy is going to get really excited. Okay, so let's add the breath in this video. So inhale, open. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. You pause here. I'm not stopping in this video, but you pause here for a few rounds of breath. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Full Uttanasana. Inhale, Urdhva Namaskarasana. Exhale, Tadasana. Okay, so there you have it, your Vinyasa A sun salutation broken down. We will do Vinyasa B in the weeks ahead, but if you need a little more help on the alignment of certain poses, trace our videos back. I know we have high plank, we have down dog. We will be doing a full Chaturanga video in the weeks ahead. So just keep looking back and you should be able to find a breakdown of some of these videos. Alright, until then, we'll see you on your mat tomorrow morning. Make sure you practice. I would recommend anywhere from 1 to 3 to 5 to 7 rounds of Vinyasa A. Watch back for classical sun salutations if you don't know that one. It's always good to have a variety of practice available every single day because your body changes and what you need changes every day. So we'll see you tomorrow on your mat. Remember to hashtag do more yoga and aham yoga so we can follow your challenge with you. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you want more videos. Bye-bye.